Hello everyone. Good morning. Good morning all the viewers. It's such a great morning today and pleasant experience for all the panelists who are here. We have been talking about different topics based on parenting, and today also we are having some unique topic. It's on grandparents. So grandparents are the major source of fulfillment to all our children. Every family is different, and the role of grandparents play different roles in every family. So I would like to welcome all the panelists today, the parenting experts, to discuss something about the parent or the grandparent. So initially, I would like to welcome Alok ji also here, who is the bonding expert in parenting. Alok ji, I would like to ask you one thing. What are the memorable moments you would like to share that you had with your grandparents? And what do you think, grandparents, is it good to have grandparents living together with parents? I mean, with children, or you prefer to have grandparents stay away? What is your opinion?
So, thank you very much, Kanis. First of all, good morning, everyone, all the panelists and all the viewers. And it's my pleasure to answer this particular question. Reason being, I'm very close to my grandparents and I have a different take on all the relationships. When I talk about grandparents, मैं कहता हूँ कि वो एक बड़े पेड़ की तरह होते हैं. They give us sheds, right? They teach us so many things. Now, the question here is, कि हमारे बच्चों के साथ पेरेंट्स का और ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स के रहने का व्हाट इज द इफेक्ट एंड हाउ दे शुड बी. सो इफ आई टॉक अबाउट माय एक्सपीरियंस विथ माय ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स, इट हैज बीन रियली फैंटास्टिक. रीजन बीइंग, आई कम फ्रॉम अ टिपिकल विलेज एरिया. मैं गांव से बिलोंग करता हूँ और गांव में जो बॉन्डिंग होती है पेरेंट्स ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स की बच्चों के साथ, बायोलॉजिकली ऑल्सो इट इज प्रूवन दैट एवरी ऑल्टरनेट जनरेशन हैज द सिनर्जी, राइट? ये आपको 10th के बायोलॉजी में भी पढ़ाया गया होगा. सो ऑल्टरनेट जनरेशंस ऑलवेज जेल, दैट इज वन. नाउ इफ यू सी द ओल्डर जनरेशन, दे हैव लेड देयर लाइफ, उन्होंने पूरी जिंदगी अपनी निकाल दी है एक पर्टिकुलर सोच के साथ, एक पर्टिकुलर वे ऑफ लिविंग के साथ. एंड दैट लिविंग एंड टूडेज लिविंग हैज एंटायरली बीन चेंज्ड. 50 साल पहले की जिंदगी जहाँ पे टेक्नोलॉजी कुछ भी नहीं होती थी, अभी पूरी पूरी जिंदगी हमारी टेक्नोलॉजी के ऊपर डिपेंडेंट है. नाउ व्हेन वी हैव 3 जनरेशंस लिविंग टुगेदर, द ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स, पेरेंट्स एंड द चिल्ड्रन, वो एक ज्वाइंट फैमिली का जो कॉन्सेप्ट होता है, जो पहले हमारे इंडिया में इट हैज बीन प्रूवन दैट, उसमें क्या होता है ना, द लॉट ऑफ लर्निंग्स हैपनिंग साइमल्टेनियसली. व्हेन इट कम्स टू न्यूक्लियर फैमिली, उतना लर्निंग नहीं हो पाती. और यदि मैं बात करूं टेक्नोलॉजी की और एडजस्टमेंट की, तो हमारे पेरेंट्स हमारे लिए जब हम बच्चे होते हैं, दे एडजस्ट अ लॉट. व्हेन इट कम्स टू आर चिल्ड्रन, हम अपने बच्चों को सिखाते तो हैं, बट समहाउ देर इज सम गैप बिटवीन अस, आर चिल्ड्रन एंड द ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स. सम व्हाट आई फील, ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स आर लेफ्ट बिहाइंड. रीजन बीइंग, दे आर नॉट एबल टू लर्न दैट मच बिकॉज दे हैव लीड देयर एंटायर लाइफ इन अ पर्टिकुलर फैशन. अब उनको 50 साल और 70 साल में हम कुछ नई चीजें सिखाएंगे, दे may not be that way a good learner, and we leave them somehow, they are left behind. So my experience, if I talk about since morning, my grandma or my grandpa used to take me along with me. सुबह सुबह पहले उठ करके कुछ खाने को दे दो, बच्चा है, और उसके बाद वो अपने साथ खेतों में लेके जाते थे. वहां से लेके आया तो हैंडपम्प पे अपने साथ नहलाते थे. उसके बाद इफ यू डोंट हैव एनीथिंग तो बैठ करके कुछ ना कुछ, और वो गेम्स खेलते थे, चाहे वो ताश हो, चाहे लोगों के साथ बैठ के खेलना हो. प्लेइंग कार्ड्स यूज टू बी वन मेजर थिंग विच यू रिमेम्बर ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स यूज टू प्ले, और वो ग्रुप होता था उनके साथ, हम बैठ के देखते थे एंड वी लर्न, उनकी बातें सुनते थे, कहानियां सुनते थे, और सोशल इशूज भी टॉपिक होते थे उसी प्लेटफॉर्म पे वाइल प्लेइंग. सो आई लर्न अ लॉट. उसके बाद दोपहर में खाना साथ में बैठ के खाते थे एक ही थाली में, एंड दे यूज टू अपने हाथ से, जिसको खेते हैं ना, अपने हाथ से खिलाना. सो वी मिस ऑल दोज थिंग्स. इवनिंग में दे विल ब्रिंग सम फ्रूट्स और समथिंग, दे विल कॉल ऑल द चिल्ड्रन, और वहाँ पे वो जो एक प्यार का माहौल होता था. से इट्स नॉट ऑलवेज गुडी गुडी गुडी, बट एक जो मेमोरीज जो होती हैं वो अच्छी वाली मेमोरीज ज्यादा याद रहती हैं। कई बार डांट भी खानी पड़ती है, कई बार शायद हमें समझ नहीं आता है, ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स टेल अस समथिंग, हमें लगता है कि नहीं, दिस इज, ये तो बकवास है, इट डजेंट फिट हियर विथ आर काइंड ऑफ टाइम। सो इट्स अ मिक्स एंड मैच ऑफ ऑल द थिंग्स, बट इफ यू आस्क मी टू समराइज, आई विल से ऑल द जनरेशन हैव देयर एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस। हम उनसे सीख सकते हैं बिकॉज जो एक्सपीरियंस उन्होंने गेन किया दैट यू कैनॉट बाय, राइट? सो वो एक्सपीरियंस को सीखें और उनकी फीलिंग्स के साथ यदि हम जुड़ जाए ना, तो यू ऑलवेज हैव अ बेटर लाइफ। दिस इज वॉट ऑल आई नीड टू से। थैंक यू।
Thank you, wonderful thought, Alok ji. Even I felt that emotional closeness that you had with your grandparents is reflected in you even now. That's why you have become a great bonding expert. That's
Thank
really
you very
great.
much.
Okay. Coming to our next panelist, Mr. Mahendra Thakur, who is a corporate trainer and a parenting expert again. Welcome, Mahendra ji. I
Ganesh,
would
thank you
like
for having me in the discussion.
yes, thank you. Okay, so just tell me one thing. Why kids want to stay with their grandparents? Why do they prefer to be with their grandparents?
Very, very valid question. And ask a child why they want to be with their, dada, dadi, nana, nani, and you will get some of the fantastic answer. So I asked the same question to my daughter. Why you like dadi? And she told me, because dadi gives me something to eat. So I said, I also give you something to eat. Mama also gives you something to eat. Then she told me, no, but she doesn't, scold at me, and she doesn't shout at me. All right, got it. So that's where, you get the clue. So before we know the answer of this question, we have to first realize each individual separately. So who is a grandparent, who is parent, and who is child, and what they are going through in the respective age bracket. So we'll start with the child. Child, as you all are parenting expert, and the people who are watching, I'm hoping that they are parents and they have the experience. Child is a blank canvas. They have no worry and no limitations. All they want in their life is 4A. That's it. Everything they are doing only to get 4A. The first A is attention. They do everything to get attention. Attention, attention. They will play, they will break things, they will shout, and they will keep on telling you something just to get your attention. And they are expert in that. Better than any salesman in the world, they know how to get your attention. So they need attention. They need acknowledgement. Second A, they need acknowledgement. So when they do something, they want to see whether you are watching it or not. But they need acknowledgement. Third is they need acceptance. They want somebody to love them unconditionally, instead of giving gyan, lecture, or on a big talk. Fourth A is appreciation. They want appreciation for every little or a big thing which they are doing. Now, remember these 4 A, okay? And see, compared to parents and grandparents, who is giving them more attention? Parents or grandparents?
Of
Grandparents. Who's giving more acknowledgement? Yes, beta, sahi kiya, very good, shabash. Who's giving more acknowledgement? Or this is appreciation also for grandparents. Who is accepting them? As a parent, we are so much focusing on making them a better human being or better student or better behaved child that we are somewhat also criticize them compared to accept them as they are, right? We want to make them something, that's where we are visualizing that goal. But grandparents, they know, they have seen the world, so they know, जो जैसा है वैसे ही ठीक है. So acceptance, acknowledgement, appreciation and attention. Grandparents give them more. So that's the answer number one, why they would like to stay with their grandparent. Now let's see who's parent.
Parent is somebody who at that particular age who is trying to do what I teach to every parent. So as you might be knowing, I teach 3P formula, okay? 3P formula stands for personal, professional, and parenting. As a parent right now, I have my own personal life. I'm struggling through my lot of limitation, habits. I also have a lot of good things about me in my personal life. My personal life affects my professional life, as you already know. So right now I'm establishing my career. I'm getting promotion, or probably I have some financial loss, something I'm trying to deal with my professional life. And of course, since I have to become the parent, so I have to devote and dedicate one set of my part of my day or my life to the parenting. So that's how my time is divided. And I am trying to build something. I'm trying to raise my child. I'm trying to raise my wealth or career. And I'm also trying to become a good human being, or I'm understanding myself better in this stage. So that's the stage of parenting. Now let's see grandparents. Who are they? They are the one who have passed this stage. Now they know themselves very well. Grandparents, they have they are already settled or whatever, you know, they have gone through their professional life. So somewhat they have reached to a stable place. On a personal front also, they have gone through all the ups and downs of life. Now they have realized this is the part of life. So they have become spiritually or emotionally more elevated. And parenting, because they were also parent, they didn't have that time. So they have some kind of regret or some wish that, you know, we should have spent more time with our kid. We should have given more attention, acknowledgement and appreciation to our child. We should have done more things with our child. They are in that frame of mind. Now that's where the child comes into their life. And that too, in Hindi, there's a saying called "Mool se pyara byaj hota hai." The interest is, you know, interest look better than the principal, because that's the amount you always look for. That's what make you wealthy as well. So when a grandparent comes, they give everything which is possible to their child. Everything. And child, what he needs, he gets in a grand way from the grandparents compared to the parents. Look at, you know, two individuals. Parents, thoda kam mil raha hai. Grandparents, they are getting huge. So obviously, they would want to stay with their grandparents. So here comes the main crux of the entire discussion. What grandparents offer is more important than being or having a grandparents. So uh-huh. It's very, very important that grandparents, what they're offering, and obviously I know parents cannot offer that all the time. Please, my request to all the parents, if possible, please give opportunity for your child and your parents to gel together, bond together. That is the best gift that you can give to your child. And if somehow that is not possible, create an opportunity, bring that those feelings in your child which they could have got from their grandparents. That's the only message that I wanted to give. Thank you so much, Ganesh, for bringing me on this show. And I thank all the panel experts here.
Thank you, Mahendraji. That was a wonderful thought. The unconditional love and empathetic ears to praise and to appreciate. You know, these things are a must for a child. And you have put forth your views and thoughts that's a wonderful way of presentation. I liked the four A's that you have explained, appreciation, attention, acknowledgement, and acceptance. Really great. I liked it. Thank you, Mahendraji. And now we'll be moving on to Raseshwari. Is it okay if I call you Ras? Because she is an energy transformational coach. And she's been into parenting as well. So welcome, Raseshwari.
Thank you. Thank you, Ganesh, for having me here. And hello to everyone.
Yeah. I would like to ask you, Do you feel that grandparents spoil the children or spoil children in any aspect? What do you feel?
That's a really amazing question. Spoil. Whether grandparents spoil kids, their grandkids or not. So most of the time, most of the parents at some point of their life might have felt that their parents are spoiling their kids. But I would like to ask that, have you ever tried to see that what kind of energy you are creating when you are saying spoil? Because spoil has a very heavy energy associated with it. And being an energy transformational coach, I would say nobody would ever spoil their kid, whether parents or grandparents. Reason, the real meaning of spoil in old dictionary, it is to destroy or to impair, means to harm. So parents can never try to destroy their kids or not even grandparents, right? So when we keep on saying that, you know, whether grandparents are spoiling or our parents are spoiling our kids, we are actually creating that energy again and again. And thus it starts destroying something in our life or basically relationships. So what happens is the relationship between the grandparents and the not kids, but our relationships get spoiled with our in-laws. So this happens. And what if we can actually just shift it within few seconds? So I can just give you one example of it, that when you hear a word spoil, that my parents are spoiling my kids, what kind of feeling, not exactly feeling, what energy you can actually perceive with it. And when you say my parents pamper my kids so much, so you can just, which one is lighter for you? Definitely pamper, right? Yes, so this is what, there are many other ways also, but it's just an example that if we can actually replace spoil with pamper, so things will definitely shift immediately. And just to explain a bit more about that, I would like to share one incident a few days back. I was having a casual talk with one of my neighbors, Neha. She's around 27 years old woman, and she has a child, I guess, around 1.5 years. So she's a working woman. And during pandemic, her husband brought his parents because they were alone. So she told me that, you know, everything was going fine in the beginning. And, you know, now I'm totally fed up and I'm not able to actually handle it more. And she was so tensed and so angry. So I thought something might have happened bigger, some big issue. So out of concern, I just asked what happened exactly. So she said that my in-laws are spoiling my kids. I said, really? And she said, they're not realizing that they're making my life so difficult. And I was still didn't get it. Like, you know, how come they are doing that? And I said, what really happened? She said, the whole day they keep my son in their lap. And even if I say that, mama, let him play on the floor. And she says, it's okay. He's just like playing nicely in my lap now. Why you want me to just put him on the floor? And she said, being a working woman, they don't understand that once they leave, it will be so difficult for me to manage. So I said, is there something else actually that you are not happy with them? She said, no. Otherwise, they are good. Nothing like that. And I laughed. I said, see, you are actually, you know, creating a very big issue out of a very small thing. And she said, really? I mean, she was just looking at me like this. How come she's saying that? I'm so serious. I'm so tense. And she's talking like that. So I said, have you ever acknowledged what gift they are to you and to your kid? Still, she didn't get it. So I said, okay, first of all, stop saying that they are spoiling. Okay. Later, I will let you know that why I'm saying that, but just stop saying that they're spoiling. And second thing is, start acknowledging what gift or what contribution they are to you and your son. And third, you are assuming everything about your future. what gonna happen if they leave, it will happen like this. So what if they can actually stay for a few more months? Your son is already 1.5 years old and he will definitely would learn to walk within few months or something that. And what if they can actually stay till that time? And even if they want him to be in their lap, he will just run out of the lap. And you can just keep on working, keep on doing everything you want to. So I said, is it light? She said, yeah, I didn't think in that way. And I laughed, and then it was like, so most of the time I said, you are unnecessarily creating that stress in your life, right? Assuming everything and making it more complex. So I said, just do this. And first, you know, after that, once you start acknowledging, then also there will be a greater shift in your life. You will feel more easier and more lighter. And I said, let me know. And yesterday only, we again had a talk, and she said, yeah, after that, I was into that zone, you know, what gift they are to me. And I acknowledge that if they would not be here for so long, it will be really difficult for me and my son staying alone, doing the work also, because when you are at home, kids also want your attention. So she said so many things. And once I started acknowledging, I'm feeling so light, and I wish they would stay more longer with me. And that is what happens. So I always say that, you know, just instead of focusing on the things or assuming anything, just first change the energy, change the things. Once you change the energy, everything will be shifted. And wherever you are saying, guys, spoil, stop saying spoil and just replace it with pamper. Okay. Secondly, start acknowledging the things. Start acknowledging what gift they are to you, what contribution they are to you, and things will automatically shift. So nobody can actually spoil your kid. Nobody can actually spoil. That's what I
would like. Very nicely presented. Very nice, Russ.
Thank you so much.
It's a great thought that you've given. It's all based on perceptions. That's what even I feel. It's our perceptions, how we perceive things. Now, as you said about a case study, the lady, according to her, love means making her child grow. That is to make the child independent. But according to grandparents, love means pampering, maybe holding together or placing them on the laps or something like that. So the meaning of love may be different in each one's perception. So that's what even I felt. You know, it's greatly explained. Very nice. Thank you. Thanks a lot for your valuable thoughts. Now coming back to our storyteller, Ruby Ji. Welcome to this session. I would like to ask you, how would you relate children being with our grandparents? Like, what do you think? Why are kids very much attached? That attachment. What could be the reason? As Mahinder Ji said about the 4 A's, could you be a little extensive and tell us about your views?
Thank you so much, Kanis. Good morning, everyone, all the panelists and the viewers. And thank you so much for giving me this opportunity to talk about this. Yes, children are attached to the grandparents so much because grandparents have a level of patience which the parents don't have. Like Mahindaji rightly explained, they are going through a different phase of life wherein they are settling down, they are managing too many things. And at the same time, yes, they are not prepared to bring up children. At that point of time, children come up in their lives. But grandparents, in a way, they are reliving their lives. You know, probably they also went through the same things. And yes, they want to relive the moments they missed with their children at one point of time. The patience level is also very, very high. And probably they want to, you know, they were guilty about not giving that kind of time to their children. And yes, they are giving the best to their grandchildren. So there's unconditional love, there's a lot of giving happening, you know, and yes, sometimes, you know, they even point out like, you were also doing the same thing, I never scolded you like that, you know, so children feel very good, you know, their parents being scolded by somebody, there exists somebody who can talk, you know, who can suppress their parents and, you know, protect them from them. So the sense of security also happens more in the family. You know, they feel very, very secure. Like parents get harsh and grandparents never get harsh because their level of patience is very, very high. And children feel loved more. They get more attention, like Mahendra ji said. Yes, that kind of attention and that kind of appreciations probably parents miss out. And yes, grandparents provide them. So the children get everything that they need in life and a little more than their parents. So they are very much attached to their grandparents.
Wow, really, that's amazing, Ruby ji. Even I feel, you know, there are so many benefits when you live with your grandparents, like as far as the health is concerned, the health and well-being of the kids as well as the grandparents depend upon, you know, the closeness or the emotional bonding between them. Also, the endless love and support that they have, you know, with children. That's what children gain, and that is only the fortunate kids will be having this kind of chance or an opportunity when they live with their grandparents. Moreover, recent studies also have shown that, you know, the main cause, if you have your grandchildren or grandparents and grandchildren staying together, that bonding will stay away from, I mean, they can protect against all kind of depression, or it even has some, you know, brain boosting functions also, and it leads to a longer life also. So this is something amazing benefits that we get when we have, you know, these grandparents, parents staying together. The socializing, how to socialize with different generations, you know, even if you have different thoughts, how can we get into common terms? How in a family, how can we come into common terms? These are some of the things that we can, and you know, we can enhance, and children learn it very soon. That is what even I feel. So it's a great pleasure that we had the session today. We will be coming up with some other sessions, some useful sessions on parenting in the upcoming programs. So stay tuned, all the viewers. Goodbye for now.
Thank you.
Goodbye. Thank you.
Goodbye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.